हे गाइस, वेलकम टू द वीकली मूवी रिकमेंडेशंस विद संकेत। सो आज के एपिसोड के लिए मैंने बहुत ही एक स्पेशल गेस्ट को इनवाइट किया है, जिसका नाम है मृण्मयी मोरे। सो मृण्मयी मेरी बहुत अच्छी फ्रेंड है, और वो एक सिनेफाइल है, एक डांसर भी है और एक फोटोग्राफर है। सो आप उसके फोटोग्राफ्स उसके इंस्टाग्राम के फोटोग्राफी अकाउंट पे भी देख सकते हैं, और वो आज अपने पर्सनल फेवरेट मूवीज सजेस्ट करने वाली है। सो ओवर टू यू मृण्मयी।
Hi guys, my name is Mrinmayee Mure and today I'll be recommending you two of my favorite movies. Now it's surely difficult to choose these two movies, so I've chosen the ones that are always on top of my mind. Now when I watch movies from a cinematographer or a DOP's point of view, and that's not only because that's what I want to do in future, but you know, ever since I was a kid and I used to come out of the theaters and I used to be like, you know, even if the movie is nice, there used to be some shots and some scenes that used to stay in my mind, and I used to be like, wow, that was so beautiful, wow, that shot was so magical. And you know, as later, like as I grew up, I understood that the magic that I'm so mesmerized by is created by a cinematographer. So today's two movies that I am going to be recommending are like a cinematography special. So let's see the first one. So the first film that I'm going to recommend you is The Favourite, directed by Yorgos Lanthimos and shot by Robbie Ryan. Now this film is a case study in itself, especially for cinematographers, because the director and cinematographer have come together and created magic. They have pushed beyond their limits and they have broken all the rules. This film is shot almost entirely in natural light, except for two or three scenes. They use artificial light, otherwise it's completely shot in natural light, and they have shot it on 35 mm because this film is based in 18th century. So you know, to bring that rustic look and that beauty of 18th century, they have shot it on a 35 mm. Now why I like this movie so much is really because of the way it shots, especially those moments that Queen Annie, that is Olivia Colman, is vulnerable. Oh my god, those moments are literally to die for. They have used a wide angle lens or fisheye lenses, and they are usually high, absolute top angle shots or absolute low angle shots. And when these shots are shot using wide lens or the fisheye lens, they really give this sense of space, because they show a huge area. They give a sense of space, but at the same time they also give this feeling of distortion and claustrophobia, which is exactly what are the emotions that Queen Annie is going through in those times. And if those shots were not shot the way they did, it would have been really plain. Like, no matter how beautiful or stellar her Olivia Colman's performance is, it would not have brought that emotion out that well if it wasn't shot the way it was. So I mean, you really have to watch this film for such moments, especially the end sequence is something that every person who has watched this movie talks about. It's really the most spoken about sequence, and it's absolutely historic. So do watch this film, because it's beautiful. It's like a perfect painting, you know. So do watch this film. Now the second film that I'm going to recommend to you guys is Bulbul, directed by Amrita Dutt and shot by Siddharth Dewan. Now this film is set in 1881 Bengal Presidency, a time when Britishers still ruled India and child marriage was still practiced. So in the beginning of the film, a 5 or 6 years old Bulbul is married off to a rich old landlord called Indraneel. Now Indraneel also has a twin brother called Mahendra, and Mahendra has some mental issues. So because of that, Indraneel is the main guy, he's the older brother as well, and Bulbul is his newly married choti badi bahu. Now since Bulbul is only 5 or 6 years old, she really connects with Indraneel's younger brother Satya, and they grow up together in the film. And the starting of the film only, they talk about the story of a chudail that lives on trees in that village that everyone is scared of. Now, Anvita Dutt has taken a folklore and she has put a feminist lens on it and presented an absolutely fresh and relevant story to everyone. Later in this film, this chudail is on a killing spree and she's killing all these men. And Satya, who has recently returned from London, he's just not ready to believe that it's a chudail who is killing all these men. He thinks that there is a guy behind it. So, I mean, watch the film and find out for yourself who the real killer is. So I'm not going to talk about the film much because I want you all to see it. What I'm going to talk about is the strong imagery that is used in this film. You know, traditional mainstream Bollywood films, they use dialogues or songs or tacky dance numbers to show, you know, change in events or to show change of emotions, etc., etc. But in this film, Anvita Dutt and Siddharth Dewan has used imagery to show emotional transformation or to show change in events. Even the past and this movie is non-linear structure, so they keep shuffling between past and the present. The past is shown in cooler tones, so there's more of blue and pastel shades, and the present is shown in warm colors, and red is the dominant color of present. Now, red is a color that is symbolic of fertility, symbolic of love, lust, anger, and so many such strong emotions. And Anvita, that truly leaves it up to you as to what you make of that color red, because our protagonist is feeling a range of these emotions. So it's up to you what you have to pick on. And the red color is a really smart choice, so it's amazing. Now, there is a striking image that has stayed in my mind, and every time I hear this name Bulbul, this image comes off my mind. It's actually two. One is of the chudail sitting on the amazing mango trees and this big red moon in the background, and the second shot is again of the chudail in a bathtub filled with blood, and she has embraced onto a little girl in that bathtub, and there's just a dolly shot that's just moving ahead towards her. And there's this amazing sound design that just complements the scene. And oh my god, that scene is so strong and poetic. And this is not just one scene, there are multiple scenes like that in this film. And you have to watch the film to, you know, truly understand the magic and the brilliance of this visual storytelling. And I'm so happy that there are more movies that are, you know, using this style of storytelling. So that's really amazing. And you can watch this film on Netflix, and you can watch The Favorite on Hotstar. Okay. Also subscribe to Sanket's channel for amazing, amazing movie recommendations. Like, Sanket is my go-to guy for all movie recommendations and documentary recommendations too. I mean, I'm just amazed at how many things he watches. So yes, if you want amazing movie recommendations, subscribe to this channel, hit the like button, and press the bell icon so that you get so that you get notification every time he uploads a new video. Bye.